quiet.
Mark it.
57, take one.
Frank Zappa slaat wederom toe. Deze befaamde leider van de popgroep, de Mothers of Invention, componist en muzikus, heeft zich nu ook op de film gestort. Jarenlang heeft Zappa zich in de stilte van zijn Hollywoodwoning op deze spectaculaire actie voorbereid. Zijn film heet 200 Motels, een fantasie-rockopera over de bizarre avonturen van een popgroep op tournee. Alle bruikbare ervaringen en materiaal uit de afgelopen jaren worden erin verwerkt.
This tape version of it that you hear is from the Uncle Meat album. It was the original recording of it. And it's been changed around somewhat to suit the purposes of the film version of 200 Motels. In this next section, the soprano soloist is supposed to be a girl from a low-budget rock and roll magazine that's interviewing me, and she has a text that she recites on this melody here. Right here. She's singing, "When's your next LP to be released, and how long have you been growing your hair? Have you been to England yet, and how do they like your music over there?" And then the chorus goes, "Over there, over there." She says, in an aside to the audience, "I bet the first time that you went to England that it was really far fucking out and groovy, and it was really groovy vibes, and it was so European. And I can just see you guys now wandering around Europe, going to all these exotic places like Paris, Rome, Essen, and the Vienna Woods. Dit is Centerville, een typisch stadje uit het middenwesten van Amerika, van latten en karton opgebouwd in de Pinewood Studios bij Londen, waar Zappa's film werd opgenomen. 200 Motels laat zien wat er allemaal kan gebeuren als er in zo'n voorbeeldig Amerikaans stadje voor één nacht een popgroep op bezoek komt. Zappa en zijn hoofdrolspelers Mark en Howard repeteren hier op zondagmiddag in de verlaten studio een autorit door de straten van Centerville.
Say, you like my new car?
Wow. It's real cool. Do you know how to get to the cheesy motel?
Which one is it?
The one by the airport. We've... Oh, man.
What?
It's real cool. You know how to... Do you know how to get to the cheesy motel without smashing into the butcher shop?
Which one are you staying at?
Oh, the one by the airport.
Keep it up, Ian! Ian!
We gotta get up early and fly out of here in the morning, you know?
Oh, yeah, really?
Oh, yeah, really.
Where do you play tomorrow night?
Oh, Tierra del Fuego.
Oh, yeah.
And then there's that barbecue at Mutt's.
Oh, you're so professional.
Oh!
I mean, the way you get to travel to all those exotic places. Do you really have a hit single in the charts with a bullet?
Listen, honey. Would I lie to you just to get in your pants?
Don't talk to me that way!
Keep your eye on the road!
I am not! I am not a groupie!
Frank Zappa laat weinig aan het toeval over. Regisseur Tony Palmer krijgt voortdurend duidelijke instructies van Zappa hoe hij de verschillende scènes opgenomen wil zien. De film moet in een recordtijd geproduceerd worden. 3 weken voor script, muziek en balletrepetities. En voor de opname zelf is slechts 1 week beschikbaar. Per dag moet zo'n 20 minuten kant-en-klare film geproduceerd worden. En dat kan alleen met behulp van de televisietechniek. Opnemen en monteren gebeurt daarbij tegelijkertijd.
Tony Palmer, you are the director of 200 Motels. What kind of conception do you have?
Well, I think Frank has had this dream for so long now that I think even he has become unsure as to what exactly the dream constitutes. It's a kind of mixture of childhood fantasies, adolescent fantasies, and now grown-up fantasies all somehow strung together to make some kind of enormous nightmare that he may or may not have had at some point in his life. And one's problem as a director is trying to unfathom that dream and make some kind of coherent sense of it.
200 Motels zou oorspronkelijk door de VPRO-TV geproduceerd worden. Toen dat door geldgebrek onmogelijk bleek, was United Artists geïnteresseerd in de 200 Motels als filmproductie. Zappa kreeg $750.000 toen hij het 4 pagina's dunne script liet lezen. Producer Jerry Goetz.
Why are you as a producer interested in 200 Motels?
Strictly because of the creative aspects of it. I think what Frank had done creatively from a musical point of view as well as a storytelling point of view is so fresh that it excited us. That's why we really got involved in it. I think he's a brilliant talent. And the whole feeling of 200 Motels from the point of view of what he is trying to say.
Mm-hmm. What is he trying to say?
Excuse me, I'll put this down. Yeah. I believe what he's trying to say is he's trying to make a statement with regard to what happens to all these people on the road in the minds of the people that are not on the road, if you know what I mean. And a lot of what he is saying, I think, will go over the heads of some of the people that are not familiar with what's happening today in the rock and roll scene, etc. But I think he's done it immaculately and trying to tell a story in its proper text, the way the story should be told, and that's through music.
Do you see any commercial potential in it?
I sure as hell hope so.
Q Gary! Wake up, for Jesus Christ's sake. Thank you, Barry. We're going to take that shot of the violin.
In de regiewagen worden de beelden aaneengeschakeld en die nodig van optische effecten voorzien.
Come on, Gary.
Het geluid wordt opgenomen op de mobiele 16-sporen recorder van de Rolling Stones. Naast de Mothers of Invention en een koor speelt ook nog het 90-man sterke Londense symfonieorkest mee. Dirigent Gary Howard en zijn stoffige muzici zitten opgesloten in het concentratiekamp waarover Centerville blijkt te beschikken.
Right, stop. Stop, BT. Stop, BT. They've got to reload the 16 train.
Well, essentially what we do is to record the whole operation on color videotape. The color videotape has three primary colors, red, green, and blue. And the old Technicolor process had also three primary colors, red, green, and blue. So we put two pieces of the jigsaw puzzle together and said, ha-ha, well, if the two are the same in this way, it must be possible to transfer color tape to color film using three primary colors, red, green, and blue. So we began to experiment with transferring color tape in this way. The initial problem was that the poor quality of the television picture didn't stand up to examination when you showed it on an enormous cinema screen. You saw, for example, you saw lines. Mm-hmm. But fortunately,
distortions.
And distortions, yes. But now we found a way around that. And in fact, the color that we are able to make with color television is rather better, we think, than the equivalent of 35mm film.
Mm-hmm. At last, a new British invention, eh?
Well, it's a yes.
John, start on the hour. Can you see a good shot of Ringo, John, having told you to do that? Oh, that's a nice day. Thank you, thank you. Coming to mixed one, mixed one.
The Mothers of Invention spelen de hoofdrol en zichzelf in 200 motels. Zappa is niet alleen hun muzikale leider, maar tegelijkertijd hun werkgever. Die relatie leidt tot allerlei spanningen die de groep 's avonds op de motelkamer afreageert.
Hallo! Hallo!
Well, the character I play is a great guy. You see, right away that gives me a start. On the other hand, half of it's reality and half of it isn't. You know, where the line is, it's sometimes even hard for the players to tell. You know, it's just that when you look at your script, some lines come easier than other lines, you know, and usually those are the ones that you've said before or feel that you could say, quite honestly, you know, and some of the things were made up. And it comes out that way.
Sounds inviting. Ian is starting to look good to me.
Dear Ruth. Must be his dream or sock.
I just calmed down there.
Ever since you left the jazz world to seek fame and fortune in the rock and roll industry.
Rock and roll? What do you mean rock and roll? This fucking band doesn't even play rock and roll. It's all that comedy crap.
If you're not a professional actor, if you're not trained to act, to be somebody else all the time, the easiest thing for you to do when you only have a week to make a movie is just to be yourself on the screen. So the lines that the people speak in the film, with the exception of some of the real fantasy characters like the vacuum cleaner or what Theodore Bikel says, are all based on the actual speech patterns and lifestyle of the people who are in the group.
You don't use this technique as a kind of psychological therapy for your members of the group?
Well, some people have suspected that, but I wouldn't say that's the prime purpose of the film.
What is it then?
The prime purpose of the film? Oh, that's to be revealed later.
Chris Nark.
Just like home.
Thank you.
De stofzuiger van Frank Zappa, een apparaat met ongedachte mogelijkheden, speelt ook in 200 motels een opvallende rol. De stofzuiger is verliefd op de vrouw van een watersalamanderkweker, terwijl de kweker op zijn beurt weer verliefd is op de stofzuiger. De stofzuigerrol wordt gespeeld door de roadmanager van de Mothers, van wie de tekst zegt dat zijn voorkeur naar KLM-stewardessen uitgaat.
Do you expect any problems with the sensor?
I can't answer that. I really can't. Honestly, I can't answer that.
You are in the business. So.
I think there will obviously be a problem in the United States. In the foreign countries, I don't think there will be that problem. But in all honesty, beyond the lyrical content of the picture, it is not a obscene picture in any sense of the word. It's more anti-sex than it is pro-sex.
Martin walks over in here. You just come over and stand near the side of the organ and watch from the background. Same with George.
I may better do it from this side.
Using these lines on the boom.
You are Forma.
No.
So, all right, let's do it. I'll come in. Come in with my briefcase. I see all of this thing. Yeah. I'll go. Bing! Everybody wakes up. How do they know that I go pink?
So, general sweep, so they see that you're getting Martin back there and everybody. You're waking them all up.
I will go. Your forma.
Yeah. You'll go what?
Hello. I'll go.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Your forma.
Be practical, these things are what? Okay.
And as it sweeps around, everybody should just
everybody
sort of
wakes up as I
sweep.
Take them
off.
Okay. Oh. Well, you may call me Rance Mohammed.
We already did. I called you Rance, and he called you Mohammed a few minutes ago at the beginning of that song.
That's a confession. I called you Rance. He called you Mohammed.
Okay.
Yeah.
I called you Ranch. I called you Rance. He called you Mohammed a few minutes ago at the beginning of that song.
Of course you did, lads. I was sitting across the road in a fake nightclub with an Indian gentleman. Suddenly, I sensed a need on your behalf to communicate with me. There was a need, wasn't there? Or you wouldn't have called, would you?
Theodore Buckel, you have been in many movies. 20, I think.
30, more than
30 already. Why are you in 200 motels?
Well, because I was intrigued by the whole idea. It was no more than an idea when Frank came to me first. He came with exactly, I think it was 15 pages of an outline. That was all there was. There was no more. But it was intriguing. It was interesting. And Frank himself is as you've met him, you know, is a very exciting personality. So this film will either be a complete flop, chaos, or an extraordinary film. There'll be nothing in between.